Hi, I'm Mariana from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll show you how to use Customer Journey Builder to create dynamic, automated marketing paths. When you automate your marketing, it can save you time and helps you build a personalized experience for your contacts, which could drive engagement and sales. Before we get started, here's an important thing to note. Depending on your plan, your access to Customer Journey Builder could be limited, so check out our pricing page for details. Now, let's dive into Mailchimp. To start, click Automations in the sidebar, and then click Overview. We're going to build a new journey from start to finish, so click the Build from Scratch button. Then you'll name your journey and choose your audience. My business is The Potted Planter. It's a fictional plant brand for teaching purposes. I want to welcome my new subscribers to my email list, and I'd like them to explore the products on my website. I'll also include a discount code just in case they're ready to buy. With that in mind, I'll name this journey Welcome Journey. For my audience, I'll choose The Potted Planter, and I'll click Start Building. The first step is to choose a starting point, which determines who will enter your automation. So it helps to have a strategy in mind now. Think about who you want to target and what actions you want them to take. When you start with a clear goal, you'll have a better idea of how to structure your automation. This structure will take form of a journey map, which visually represents all paths a contact can take. So it's like a blueprint of your automation. Of course, to begin, we need to choose that starting point. If a contact meets the conditions you've set for a starting point, they'll be added to your journey map. For instance, you may want your contacts who have viewed your webpage or anyone who has responded to your survey to enter your map. When you're ready to make a selection, click Choose a Starting Point. Some of our popular starting points are displayed here in the tiles, but you can also search under categories like contact activity and shopping activity. Each journey map can have up to 3 starting points. I want to welcome all of my new email subscribers, so I'll just choose Signs Up for Email. You can include contacts you've imported. For example, maybe you've uploaded a list of contacts through a CSV file. You can add a filter to refine who will enter the journey map through this starting point. These filters are based on details in a contact's profile, their interactions with your marketing, and more. Once you're done with your setup, click Save Starting Point, and welcome to the journey map. If you click Edit Settings by the gear icon, you can set a marketing objective, and this helps Mailchimp provide you with more personalized reports and recommendations. I'll choose Nurture Relationships as my objective. If your goal or strategy changes, you can edit your objective later. Now, I'll go over journey points. These are rules and actions that make up a journey map. Click Add a Journey Point to bring up your options. First, let's take a look at actions. These tell our system to perform tasks like send an SMS or send an email. Send email is the first action I'll use. I'll name this email Welcome and click Save. I won't go over the rest of the setup in detail, but normally you'd adjust the to and from name, enter a subject line, set the schedule and tracking, and design your email. That's all for this part, so I'll click Close to get back to the map. To add another journey point, click the plus sign. This time, let's look under Rules. In Mailchimp, rules determine how and when a contact moves through the map. I want to send a follow-up email with a discount, but I don't want to send this right away. So I'll add a time delay rule. This rule prevents a contact from moving forward until a set time has passed. I'll set this to 2 days and click Save. After the time delay, I'll add another send email action, and I'll name this email Welcome Discount. And to finish up, I'll click Save and Close. All right, I think this map is just about ready to go. Keep in mind, your contacts won't enter the automation until after you turn it on. If you set a marketing objective, you'll see a Turn On button near the X, and if not, the button will read Continue. I'm all done here for now, so I'll click the X to return to the overview page. Let's say you've turned on your journey map. What's next? Well, it's important to regularly check in on your journeys. That way, you can see what's working and what could use improvement. In the Recent Journeys section, you'll find the status of your latest automations and stats on your contact's progress. For a more detailed look, click View Report. If the journey you want to analyze isn't visible, click View My Journeys to see a complete list. The last thing I'll cover is how to use pre-built journeys. These are great if you want to get started quickly or if you just need some inspiration. You might not have access to all of our pre-built journeys, so check out the details of your plan on our pricing page. To get started, click the button for Choose a Pre-built Journey. Let's take a look at AI-powered journeys. Intuit Assist works like a marketing assistant. It generates automations and emails, so all you have to do is review and publish. Intuit Assist is in beta, and it's available to certain customers with premium, standard, and legacy plans in select countries. Currently, we offer Intuit Assist in English only. Its features and capabilities vary by plan, which could change. To learn more, visit MailChimp.com. Moving on, you will find pre-built journeys in categories like find and welcome new contacts, nurture leads, and plenty of others. You can also use the drop-down menus to filter your search. To give you an example, I'll click Apps and Integrations and choose Shopify. I'm excited to show you how personalized a journey can get, so I'll click Target Contacts who view specific products in your Shopify store. After you click on a pre-built map, you'll see a description and a preview. When you find a map that works for you, just click Use This Journey. Don't forget, pre-built journeys are customizable. You can add or delete journey points to fit your needs. That's about all I have for this video. Thanks for following along. As for next steps, try building a journey map. If you're new to this, a welcome journey is a good place to start. To learn more about Customer Journey Builder, visit our Help Center for articles and videos.